Welcome all of you. We have started paper number 9 inorganic chemistry, in which newly we have started unit number 1, acids, bases and non-aqueous solvents, in which in last video we have discussed regarding the different concepts of acids and bases, that is Arrhenius concept, Bronsted-Lowry concept, Lewis concept and Lux-Flood concept. And now we will see details regarding the Pearson's HSAP concept. Then what is a HSAP or SHAP? In this lecture we will see details about the Pearson's concept. So the scientist Pearson, that is R.G. Pearson, in the year of 1963 developed the qualitative correlation between Lewis acids and Lewis bases by classifying them into two categories, that is first one is a hard and soft, and this qualitative concept explains the stability of metal complexes and mechanism of their reactions. So this concept is also known as hard and soft acids and bases, and in short form it is called as SHAB concept or HSAB concept. So this theory is simple one, which was developed by Pearson, which gives details regarding the chemical information. So this qualitative definition of HSAP was converted to a quantitative one by using the idea of polarizability. So this HSAP concept depends upon the polarizability power. If a less polarizable atom or ion is called hard one, and more easily polarized atom or ion is called as soft one. So according to it, hard acid having the characteristics like high positive charge on the atom, hard acids having small size but not easily polarizable. And what is about the hard base characteristics? Hard base having low polarizability, high electronegativity but not easily oxidized. Then in case of soft acid, the characteristics are low positive charge, large size and easily oxidizable property, and soft acids having highly polarized ability or highly polarizable. In case of soft base, high polarizability, diffuse donor orbitals, low electronegativity and easily oxidized. So these are the characteristics of hard acid, hard base, soft acid, soft base. So overall, in summary, some characteristics and differences of hard acid, soft acid and hard base, soft base is given below. In case of hard acids having small ionic radius but soft acids having large ionic radius. Hard acids having high positive charge, here low positive charge. Here hard acid low electronegativity, soft acid intermediate electronegativity. And hard acids show high energy LUMO but soft acids show low energy LUMO. Similarly in hard base, small radius but soft base having large radius. Hard bases show high electronegativity value but soft base shows intermediate electronegativity value. Hard base weak polarizability but soft base having high polarizability. Here high energy for LUMO and low energy for HOMO in case of soft, hard base and soft base. So these are the general characteristics of hard acids and soft acid, similarly hard base and soft base. Then these are the examples. In exam they will ask, that is, which of the following is the hard acid one. For example, here H plus, lithium plus, sodium plus, potassium plus, rubidium plus and cesium plus. Similarly 2 plus ions, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. 3 plus ions, aluminium 3 plus, gallium, are act as a hard acids. and these are the examples of hard acids. But in exam they will ask one of the example. For example, Na plus is which of the following? Hard acid, soft acid, or hard base, soft base. Then option correct answer is hard acid in case of Na plus. Similarly H plus, and in case of soft acids, that is Au plus, Ag plus, copper plus, mercury plus, cadmium plus, platinum, palladium, all these are soft acids. And in between them there are borderline acids which show some properties of hard acids and some properties of soft acids. Examples of borderline acids are Fe2 plus, Mn2 plus, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc, lead, tin, arsenium 3 plus, antimony 3 plus, and bismuth 3 plus. Similarly, hard bases, examples of F minus, fluorine minus, water, OH minus, O minus minus, ammonia, NO3 minus. These are the examples of hard bases. In objective, they will ask like this: OH minus is the example of which of the following, or F minus is the example of which of the following. And in case of soft base, I minus, Br minus, CN minus, CO. These are the examples of soft base. Then in objective they will ask I minus is the example of which of the following, which is the example of soft base. So for exam they will ask one or two examples on the best, which is based on multiple choice questions. Which of the following is the hard acid, hard base, or soft acid, soft base? So this chart is very important. So this is the classification for simple understanding purpose. Hard acids, they are classified like this: borderline one and soft one. In previous slide we have discussed very well. Then according to HSAB principle, according to HSAB means Pearson's principle, hard acids prepare to bond with hard bases, that is hard acid combines with hard base, and soft acids prepare to bond with soft base, that is soft acids prepare to binding with soft bases. So here hard acid and hard base are not polarizable, so the bond is mostly ionic one. In objective multiple choice question they will ask hard hard interactions are which of the following, ionic or covalent? Answer is the ionic. Similarly, soft soft interaction is highly polarizable, so the bond is covalent one. In multiple choice question they will ask such type of questions. Then next we will see some applications of hard and soft acid base concept. Then first application regarding the stability of a complex. A complex would be more stable if metal and ligand both are hard or soft. For example, AgI2- is stable, but AgF2- is not stable, which is based on Pearson's HSCP concept. Here Ag plus is a soft acid while I minus is a soft base. So soft soft interactions is a stable one, so this complex is stable. But here Ag plus soft acid bus, F minus is a hard base, soft hard interactions are unstable one. So stability of complex depends on Pearson's HSCP concept. Similarly, COF6 3 minus, hard hard interactions, CO here 3 plus and F minus, hard acid and hard base respectively, is more stable than cobalt and iodine. Iodine I minus is a soft base, so here hard soft combination is unstable. So these are the applications of hard soft theory. Similar, another application is relative strength of hydroacids, HF, HCl, HBr and HF. So in aqueous solution, the relative strength of HF, HCl, HBr, HBi can be predicted. So the reaction of acid with water is, acid is HF, HX plus water. So here acid gives protons, we are getting H3O plus. So here F minus is the hardest base, will be most successfully and strongly bonded to the hard acid H plus. H plus is a hard acid and F minus is a hard base, so hard hard combination is a strong one, hence HF will be highly stable. So it is therefore least dissociated hence acid strength increases as so HI is a more strong acid as compared to HF1, which is based on Pearson's HSCP concept. This type of chart will be asked in multiple choice question. What is the correct sequence of acid strength? So here weak acid is a HF, then HCl, HBr, and strong one is a HI. So these are some applications of HSCP. Then some highlights of the limitations. So here hard and soft classification is useful concept, no doubt, but it has some tricky limitations. One of them is a prime limitation of HSCP's concept is that it is widely general and has no any direct quantitative scale of acid base strength. There is no quantitative scale. Then the inherent acid base strengths are not accounted. For example, OH minus and F minus ions are both hard bases, where OH minus is nearly 10 to 13 times stronger base than F minus ion. This correlation between hardness and inherent acid base strength is yet to be developed. So it is not clearly gives idea regarding the strength power of OH minus and A minus. Both are hard bases, but which one is a strong one, not given by Pearson. So this is the one limitation. Sometimes hard soft principle fails to keep parity with inherent acid base strength. For example, CH3 gaseous state and water in gaseous state combines, we are getting CH4 and H plus. So the reaction must be favored in the few of soft to soft combination between CH3 and H minus. But in actual practice, the combination is endothermic one. That is, here heat is absorbed plus 360 kilojoule per mole. This unfavorable entropy change does not allow the reaction to proceed. Actually, this reaction is not carried out. According to Pearson, soft-soft interactions are stable one, but due to this endothermic property, reaction cannot proceed ahead. So this is the limitation of this HSCP concept. So this is about the Pearson's HSCP concept. So thank you all of you for listening to this video.